Hello everyone, welcome to my new video. In this one, we are going to look inside the Geeetech A20M and I'm going to show you how the cables and circuits and everything organized. And there's a little bit space in there where we can put Raspberry Pi or Octopi pieces in it. I think it's a good idea to take a look inside before you purchase the printers, so how it's organized and everything. So I'm going to show it in a moment. Over here we see Z and X axis together as the upper part of the 3D printer, which is all right. We will connect everything in there, but this is the part we don't see before the purchase of the printer, and after it, if we ever open it up, we will see this part. So let's take a look at it in detail. So the entire thing is hold place with the 11 screws. So I basically took off these all screws around the corners, and this is sheet metal, so it's pretty decent. And there's the fan attachment over here, so don't forget to unplug the fan socket over there if you ever want to open it up. And let's look at deep dive what we have in here. And as you can see, this is the empty place where I think I can put Octopi setup or any other setups in here. This entire area is open. The one thing to note at this point is, as you can see guys, this is a vast open box style, so basically it's going to make some noise with the fans in here, so I think it's going to cause accumulation of the sound, and it will come out much louder as the fan spins. We will see there are two fans that are going to make noise inside this, and the print video we will hear it really clear, I think. Okay, when we first look at this is a screen section. Screen is basically held here by the four screws on the circuit, and the circuit is basically connected with this cable socket. This is the screen connections over here. So this is the motherboard that we have. I don't remember the name of the motherboard, but if anyone just very quickly recognizes it, put it in the comments down below, and after a quick research I will also tell which motherboard is this on the description down below. So as you can see, everything is organized. These are the motor connections here. Okay, over here we have all limit switch connections XYZ, and I am assuming that this one is going to the heated bed and the thermistor connections over here, but we need to double check. Power comes in here. This is the fan too that's connected to here. And over here, I assume these are going to be the thermistors related to the extruder and the other fan connection that goes to the extruder. I also see there are pins available here. I think we can basically add some functionalities to 3D printer. So there are some IO pins out here. So when we look at the power supply, this is a model, as you can see the model number over here, 24 volt power supply, pretty standard one. And as you can see, everything is connected with proper insulations and the sockets over here. So proper insulation always the key. I also see proper insulations over here too. Only section is basically that I am worried is these small openings over here at this socket. But as long as they don't move, I don't think there's a problem. But the only thing that I realize is these two little open sections over here. Other than that, the fuse box connected with insulations, the switch is again with the insulated and everything, well organized rest of the stuff. So I think this is all for the video. Let me know your comments in the description down below, and let's talk about it if you guys want to chat, and we can see what are the other details that I missed, and we can basically add more for the people who are watching this and for the people who would like to purchase this printer.
Okay guys, thank you for watching. This is the end of the inside of the Geeetech A20M video. If you guys like my videos, don't forget to subscribe and hit the thumbs up button. And as you can see, this is the inside of the Geeetech A20M. Next videos are going to be the assembly, draw settings and overall review of the printer. Stay tuned for more Geeetech A20M in action, and see you guys in the next one.